Hello everybody, I'm mehappydude and welcome back to Endless Space 2. Now, we had some troubles last time with the Lumeris. Not actually the Lumeris, they had pirates that were trying to attack them that kept attacking my fleet. I don't know how they manipulated those pirates to do that, but it made me very unhappy. Anyway, we have been building warships for a while. We're gonna have two warships that are even new warships coming this time. So we're gonna have a big fleet that's gonna be happening. And that should be cool. But as for right now, we just finished. This is just a pickup from the end of last time. So we're going to end the turn that we finished last time. See what we're going to do. We've got two turns to improve fleet management, which should be fantastic. Means bigger fleets. Bigger, badder fleets. There we go. Be the first to obtain 6 political parties in your empire. You have achieved this legendary deed. Other empires can no longer obtain it. We got 1,000 dust. Which seems underwhelming considering what we did. Oh, okay. Explore ruin type curiosities. Okay, we failed that. That is unfortunate that we failed that. Declare war, not really something that we want to do. Sorry, just looking at the options here. So we've got Ingress. What minor political we failed. Diplomatic status must be friendly. Are we in a friendly diplomatic status? I guess because we failed that, we can't do it this time. Well, we don't have enough influence points to really just take them over with culture yet. Looks like we've got two pirates that are gonna come this way and try to face some of these guys. Who are we gonna fit the- Oh, this is our original fleet. It's kind of ransacked right now. Let's move. Oh, we can't do that. We can move this right there. And then put the, tool ship on this frigate. And then repair this with 89 gold. Oh, that was loud. There we go. Okay, we've got 7 warships that are just waiting right there. These guys are getting 150 per turn again as well, but we need them to get to Ugaro first. We gotta create a little fleet first. Head to Ugaro as swiftly as humanly possible, or alienly possible. We got a logistics shoal ship that's right here. I thought something happened when it didn't happen. Okay, so we have 3 turns to colonize that outpost, which will be nice. Just hit everybody goes where everybody goes button. Exploration ship. Oh, is that a new civilization right there? It's an unknown fleet. It's an unknown empire. Oh, that planetary system is really cool. Oh, crap. Oh, well, that was embarrassing. That's real embarrassing. Sorry that happened. my audio equipment likes to yell at me while I'm doing videos, which is, you know, at this point it's yelled at me like twice, and it's losing the sting or even the humor aspect of anything. So it's not as amusing. Anyway, what do we have? Population growth, even more population growth. We completed one of the instruments. Oh yeah, it's the one that's going on. Instrument is a weird name for a warship, but whatever. I guess that they're sticking with the theme of beauty, apparently. 2 more turns for improved fleet management. We're getting close. Okay, come on. We can do this. Okay. Academy, power increased. Pilgrims, we got more people. Colonial rights, we have. Civilian ships destroyed. Okay. Where? This is Ugaro? This is the... Oh, wait, I've got an instrument with me. Okay, I'm not scared anymore. What's their ship got? Oh, it's 805 health, which is decent. It's not almost 2,000 health decent, though. So it's got 162 attack, and it's got 9 attack. Alright, well this should be fun. Let's watch this. Let's watch the ridiculous capabilities of these shields. Let's do power to shields. Let's fight. I want to see how this works out. I want to see what they could possibly do to fight this huge warship. And maybe our warship is pathetic and it's gonna make me cry, but I think I'm gonna be impressed by what we... Oh, it's real big. Okay, their ship is pretty long too. That's a cool... Who are all these pirates that are just attacking the entire world? Okay, well, so we got our hero ship. We got our hero ship right now. That's gonna be... Okay, that's a beautiful nebula. There they are. There they go. Attacking the heck out of that ship. Yep, there it is. That ship is not taking a lot of damage. Our ship isn't. Their ship is getting hit quite a bit. Their shields are really good. Does our warship not have shields? Is it just an attack warship? Because that would be a little bit sad. I feel like that warship that we have is mostly for ground assaults, which is good to know. I also feel like I could do a better job equipping it with better weapons. I mean, it's gone, and our big ship lost not even 50 health. I don't know why I'm getting so sad that it didn't get destroyed instantly, even though it barely took any damage and that was still a good victory. But still, I guess that means we need to retrofit the ships up. We need to do a little bit of retrofitting. This is about to, the fight's about to happen again, isn't it? Yep. Okay, we're not going to watch this fight because I feel like we're going to be fine again. Was I correct? I think I'm good. I think one ship versus a warship and then a hero ship and everybody else is going to be fine. Yep. That's right. What's our instrument health at now? Okay, so total he lost about 100 health to two ships, so about a 20th of his health. Let's go to that fleet. Let's heal them up for 39. Ship design. I feel like we need to improve the instrument design. Upholder design looks relatively good too. Instrument design, create a new one. Hull. Oh, wow. Yeah, that's definitely five. The five Hyperium, Arcadium class. All right, now how do we want to outfit this? We've got basic Maggie laser, damage per second plus 8. Is that all we have? Basic decay torpedoes. We don't really have any advanced weapons, do we? Okay, short range optimal for basic phased beam. For the laser, it's better at long range. Missile or the torpedoes medium or long. The slugs is a short range thing. Okay. Did we just have one weapon slot on this big ship? Oh, we do, don't we? So the rest of it, I guess, is shields and then just crew stuff. Because right now it has 300 crew. So to hold more crew, it has to have something inside of it to increase that. I wonder what it has. It's not augmented scanners. No, not nano repair bots. Ooh, goodness. Maybe I chose the wrong ship class. Ugh. Well, this has what, two weapons? No, it has four possible weapons. What's the hunter class? Oh, that's the five palladium that we don't have. Ooh. So all we really have is this one. So to summarize the last 10 minutes, then I'm gonna have to actually edit. This is why it's not really doing too much. We only have two possible weapon slots on this big ship, which is not great, honestly. Basic Maggie laser, plus 8 per second, plus 40 per second at short range, plus 19 per second. So basic phased beam looks very nice, but it's only short range for the phased beam. Lasers is only 8. Basic decay torpedoes are very good. So, oh my gosh. Alright. Alright, we get you. We've got it. It's alright. Do some shielding. Basic plasmoid shielding. And then just do some relatively easy hull stuff. Now we can do gravity engine or we can do Hyperium engine. Let's do Hyperium engine. Increased damage from weapon modules, plus 12%. Nice. Okay. This ship now has almost 500 attack. It only has 300 people, but it has 302 shields, 1600 health, 459. Okay. Alright. Enter new ship name. Missile Frigid. That's not how you spell Frigid. That's. We'll create that design. Alright. So we're at 11 minutes right now. I will say that ship design is very, very simple and very, very fun to do. I don't think Ugaro can actually help us with any of our industrial needs for these ships. They're still trying to colonize this planet, which they can do for monies. Let's have Nihal create the next ship that they're going to create is a missile frigate. Because we're going to need some actual attack on our side. Some attack on our side. See, that's 19. That's going to be 19. You know what? Let's just buy it out. Let's double down our money that we got from earlier and just buy that thing out quickly. We'll get the ship from Nihal. We'll come down here and that'll be enough. I think we've got enough warships to actually make ourselves decent now. Our research is going to be coming along. Political survey is 100% militarists, which is not good. That warship is still coming up from the south. We've got more warships coming from Aerie. So I think we're going to have enough warships. We can probably stop making them on Aerie after that one. We'll start doing something actually useful, like the xenotourism agencies, I think would be a good idea. Start doing some science buildings. Yep. It's good. It's good. Big data. 40% on ship fleets. Okay. I'm glad that our home planet has been working on science stuff, because that'll help a lot. We're ecstatic on this planet right now, which is nice. Very ecstatic. We need to get this planet able to be colonized. The barren planets, I really want to get those under the belt. We can only design this once per empire, so let's build it here. Let's build all the stuff that's once per empire in the capital, I think. I think that'd be smart. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so they're going to be working on some big projects for a while. They need to keep us in science right here. I think that's the main goal of this planet. That huge Arctic planet that we have colonized, they are at 100 science per turn. And that's one of our biggest science exports right now, is just that planet. Alright, let's end the turn right here. Well, we made a lot of cool progress. We've built missile frigates on Ugaro. Ugaro has a new missile frigate. Nihal's about to build a warship. Our warship's coming up from the south. Things are starting to move right now. Oh, we've got two of these pirate frigates that I hope leaves. Those pirate frigates are so... I didn't want them to go to my other fleet. Yeah, dingus. It looks like we have... Oh my gosh! Okay, our command points move to 14. Alright. Let's create this. We're just gonna have to compile all of this into a fleet led by... Who do we want to lead? Let's see this guy's leadership skill points. What does he have? He has damage on fleet. Okay, he has damage on fleet. The other ship has health on fleet. Ooh. They're both gonna need to lead at some point. But right now, this guy's less experienced, so I want him to become more experienced. So let's plug people into his fleet right here. Let's unassign this guy. There we go. Okay. 12 out of 14. Not bad. That's a ship of Reavers coming in, though. And that makes me worried. These guys are still rebelling? Don't they have the intergalactic supermarket things? They have infinite supermarkets. What's the... Is it infinite population? They've got mostly Horatio, right? How do they still have pilgrims? I thought we consumed them. Splice the genes. You need to reach a population of 3 population units to perform this action. Isn't there 3 population? Didn't we already do it? Oh, boy. 10 plus 10 happiness on systems with Horatio, and we're still not in the happiness market yet on that planet. Oh, man. Why is Ingress so pissed off? Do they need to get somewhere with science? Representative is not in Senate. Okay, overpopulation and minus 15 for planet. Oh. Alright, well. That's unfortunate. Is there any way to increase that happiness? That old happiness level? We're gonna need to do that, right? Because then they'll get plus 10. It's not gonna be great. So we appeased the rebellion, but that's still not gonna do anything. And that's not what I wanted to do, sorry. We can colonize, but if we take off colony rights and interplanetary stuff, this is just gonna be a cold planet that's they're not gonna like. We can go for science, or we can go for food, but either way. Either planet it's going to take a while to get to. Oh, this outpost has been nothing but a pain in my back. And neck. Pain in my neck and back. It's the old Ingress for you. Pain in the neck and back. That's their motto. We're a pain in your neck and back. Don't live here. Ooh. This is why I want the happiness laws. I should have been gone for the happiness laws at the very beginning. I was stupid. I was dumb. 50% food on systems. Righteous Fury, I think I can just abolish, but we have so many militarist representatives, and we don't have any other kind of representatives here. We can finance a campaign, intimidate candidates, roundup. Okay, well, we're gonna have to deal with the political fallout from Ingress for a while, I think. I don't see the situation getting better anytime soon. I feel like... Okay, minus 10% happiness on planet, minus 10 happiness on planet. So, oh, minus 15 happiness on planet. That's probably a big reason. So we shouldn't go to other places. Maybe we can get the governor from the scavengers to be there. The Mangwaga Modo. That should make it decently... Okay, it made it content. Right? It'll be alright, huh? Hopefully. Maybe that's just from the seduction that we did with the resources. Okay. Automate for happiness, alright? I'll leave the planet up to Mwanga Moto. He needs to just make that planet system happy. I don't care what else happens to it. Okay, our colony is being blockaded by not only the Sofons, but also the Lumeris. The great Lumeris enemy. Our warships are still going. Our exploration ship is still headed strong. They're discovering a lot of stuff up there. Oh, wow, the Sofon... Oh, this isn't good. The Sofon planets over here are very isolated from the rest of their empire, so they're going to blaze a war trail down through there at the very least. Maybe they're even just aiming for this entire top half. We're not giving them Nihal. Nihal has been a very good warship producer, and they're ecstatic right now. Mostly because I think we bribed them, right? Oh no, this is just approval stuff. Okay, cool. This stuff is all inhospitable. Also, it provides a terrible happiness decrease. Which is not fun. Anyway, I think we can just end the turn right there, I believe. And, we're almost encompassing the quest planet, or the quest system right now with our culture. Hopefully we can just own it via culture. Okay. Alright, we're gonna have to support the religious party, right? Because we can't, if we support the military party, we're just gonna lose absolutely everything. Yep, official support. Come on, religious party, no. Religious party needs to pull ahead. That's something that needs to happen. No new laws, no action outcome. This has been, the no laws thing has been stifling to our economy and play style. Oh, well, that was a brief screen tear. What do we got? System colonized on Adasir. Okay, well, they're kind of blockading it right now. So, goodness. I was looking at Adasir that was being blockaded. Why did you guys start a fight? Oh my gosh. Okay, well, I don't know why he thought going against these guys was going to be a good idea, but we're going to watch this. Well, let's do power to shield and just fight this. This guy's going up against 7 ships at once. There's one frigate in each lane. He's not a fighter. He's a corvette, I think, right? Corvettes are the smaller ones. Anyway, this is not going to be, it won't be pretty. I'm going to tell you right now. I mean, we have 3 different lanes full of ships that are going to be attacking him, and he's got nothing. He's got one. He's got one very pretty ship and a very pretty nebula, but that's basically all he's got right now. Oh, the game is trying, is very, oh my gosh. Oh no. You can't do that. I have to edit that out now. We had too many shield. We have too many ships. There were so many ships the game. I don't know if it was something that I did or what, but the game almost crashed, and then I just heard the explosions happening, and then it was done. Oh my gosh. That was terrifying. I thought we lost all that progress. In fact, because of that, we're saving this thing. We're gonna save over this. Yep. Save. There we go. Alright, that was terrifying. Well, hopefully we haven't hit the limits of what my computer can handle, because that's really, it's not a lot. What's our fleet down here like? 12 out of 14? Okay, we're gonna have to create a smaller subsection of just these warships once they get up here. Okay. Black hole discovered, plus 50 on system. Alright, well that's all the way over there, we're not really worried about that right now. I do hope we get this black hole, because that science bonus would be nice. Frigate's almost there. Let's go ahead and blockade the system. How are we doing on people? It's splitting them up between the whole fleet, I think. So we're gonna need to build some kind of... Convert one person to 300 people. Yikes. Plus 10% food to people. Plus 10%, 20% food for people. There we go. We're just gonna have to build up our military complex. I feel like that's what we have to do. Minus 10% happiness on planet. Okay. So that's gonna be a bad thing. Do we have galactic supermarkets that we have? Nope. Oh, okay, we already used those. Ooh, boy. Speaking of, now that I see that, I guess we could use religious propaganda on some of our planets. Like this one. Religious propaganda. Honestly, we can't use another missile frigate. What can we use, though? Guess we can research that. Atmosphere, study atmosphere. No. You know what, let's just leave that on religious propaganda right now. Eat a theater. We're gonna have to build you guys up for happiness. Yep, intergalactic supermarkets. Well done. Alright. Well, hopefully, honestly, my biggest worry right now is that the game crashes the next time we fight, which I hope does not happen. But it could. Plus 15,000? I wonder how that's going to happen. Anyway, population increase, wonderful. Religious propaganda, good. End turn. This ground war is going to be brutal on Zurich. It's just going to be so much. Oh, man. Well, this place is getting blockaded. Battle at Ugaro. Okay, so last time, almost crashed the computer, made me super worried. This time, we're gonna see what happens. I did save, so that if this just cuts out and then opens up again with me at the computer, you'll know why. Or if you see something different, something weird, this is what happened. You know what? We're gonna save again just to prevent that from happening, because that's terrifying. Let's save that game. Save that boy game. Alright. Let's watch this. Do it. Okay, I'm real worried. I'm real worried about this. Okay, let's hope that we can watch this. Oh, I don't trust it. I don't trust this. Oh, this isn't gonna be good. I feel a crash coming. I feel the crash coming. Oh, it's in my blood. Oh, it's gonna be right before it fires. Here we go. Okay, it didn't crash. Wonderful. Perfect. Oh, I'm so happy. Oh, that's a big cannon. Oh my gosh, that was so many missiles. That was so many missiles. Oh, man. Oh, he didn't stand a chance. Look at that. Oh, that's beautiful. Oh. Oh, that is a brutal destruction. Oh my gosh. Well, first off, glad it didn't crash. Second off, that was crazy. They took 26 dust in damages. And that was it. Those missile frigates are crazy. 596 damage per second. 162 damage per second. Or per attack, I guess. Honestly, if we got the tool, the weapon ship, and the weapon ship out of here, wouldn't be that bad. We got another instrument fleet. We're gaining people, but pretty slowly. So, okay, minor civilization discovered. Harmonious development. Unknown pacifist. Alright, cool. We sure are exploring this galaxy with that one automated ship that we have. Which is nice. It's a good thing. So right now we have three right here. If we boot out one ship, let's take out one weapon ship and put it inside the planet.
And then this other instrument ship, let's just pop it in there. Okay, there we go. Perfect. We have four warships right there. That is awesome. They're gaining people very slowly, though. Very, very slowly. And I don't know how to fix that. I don't know if they have to be inside. Let's look at how this warship gets people next turn. And then maybe we'll see. So it's at 81 right now. Let's keep track of that. And then next turn, we'll see where it got to. So 81. So it had 81. We hit next turn. And what's it at? Oh, okay. Sorry, I thought it was loading. It's still at 81. Oh, Battle of Ugaro. We don't need to watch this. This is gonna be brutal. Sorry, buddy, but you don't stand even a chance. Even if you had, like, atomic weaponry, there's no way you're gonna get through these guys. Yeah, nope. Faction assimilated. Oh, okay. Green guy's got Karis. Where's Karis? Oh, was it this Gina place? They got Gina! No, Gina, no, why, Gina? Okay, we got another instrument guy down here who's also slowly, very slowly gaining people to attack with. It seems like that's a common theme. They're all very slowly gaining. I think it's just the amount of develop. Is it just per turn there is an amount of, like, army that you have? I don't know how the system works. Is it just any excess manpower goes into the ship? Yeah, I don't know how this is gonna work. I mean, we can start a ground war. It's just that I don't want to be so unprepared. Cause let's see, that we have the total amount of people that we have on all of those ships is 1,000 out of 5,000. We have 1,000 manpower, which is very good. But I think I'm gonna need more. So let's look at this manpower. It's 1,051. Maybe we can just fly to our home planet. Maybe if, you know what? Let's take this entire fleet. Let's fly to our home planet and see if we can pick up more manpower. Because if we can, that would be incredible. Okay, all the ships that were going places, go where you were gonna go. Battle it. Oh boy. Retreat, buddy. Retreat. That's our exploration ship. Revealer. Revealer, get out of there. SOS code 5. SOS code 5. You got 3 enemy pincers coming at you. Oh boy, that was close. Well done. That was a well done retreat, buddy. You got the hell out of there. Well done. I feel sorry for that planet, though. It's still besieged by those pirates. And those were the peaceful jellyfish guys. Alright, we're already half an hour into this. The time has flown by for me on this. I'm sure it hasn't for you guys, but for me, this has been really fast. This has been fun. Those missile frigates were a great idea, honestly. Thought they were great. Let's gather a secondary fleet of these ships. Send them to the middle. Actually, we'll do that at the end of the episode. At the end of the episode, we'll send everything to Ugaro as a staging grounds, and then we'll start assaulting the planets. Because we have to start this assault sooner or later. We're about to encompass the Lore's planetary system with our culture. Nihal is still creating propaganda for the religious sector so that we can possibly get control of the Senate back and create some new laws. Population change on Idasir, which is very good. Okay, well, they're making a threat to war with us, which is not always what you want to hear from someone that you also want to have a war with. I mean, it'll be fun, but I don't want them to go after Ugaro. If they come after Ugaro, then I'll be very pissed off. It's just a warning, like 5 turns to attack, which is not fun for anybody. Okay, our research is getting done this turn, I believe. Oh, it's doing a lot of calculating. They must really mean war. I don't know if Ugaro can handle it.
It's got 10 people. It's about to start improving its military complex, though, which will be nice. Okay, so we increased people on... Ugaro got another person. They're going to move to creating a military complex now. Commercial frameworks is our next thing, and that's going to take 2 turns. Let's go to the home planet. Can they grab all the people that are here? Did they grab a few people? I don't know if they did or not. Because, again, I have no idea how the manpower system works in this game. So I think they're completely full of people. So if I do exotic rations, this construction cannot be bought out. Oh, so the people don't make infinite people, I guess. So we'll do infinite rations and then do the intergalactic thing. Xenotourism. What was the other big building that we're gonna do? Oh, this one. Okay, so we'll have these guys here for 2 turns. So we're gonna stay here, we're gonna convert one of the people into food for armies, I guess. I don't know. But overall, right now, the system has... Okay, right now it's got almost 1,200 instead of just 1,000. So I think that did help it a little bit. Ooh, Unknown Empire got 3 unique star improvements. That's very good. Oh, slingshot event finally ended, which decreases industry. Assigned skills for our wonderful leader here. Alright, there we go. Finally, apply skills. Then we can do plus 15% influence on system. Ooh, or conscription. Which is nice, but I don't think so. Plus 15% happiness on system. Also very nice. Okay, so we got to the second rank of hero. Which is cool. Population increase. Our little outpost is growing very quickly. So, after they get all the food, let's start gathering all of the people. They're only at 81 manpower. Ugh. This weapon ship is still at 100. Okay, we gotta create a new fleet. We gotta fly down here. We gotta create a new fleet, fly all the way back, fly all the way out here. Come on, there you go. Okay, Lors is about to be encompassed by our influence. Okay, commercial frameworks, we're gonna be researching this turn. Trade Company HQ is gonna be up next for the commercial development, looks like, according to this advisor. We're about to reach the 40-minute mark, which is going a little bit long for me, so I think I'm going to start to wrap things up. It's been fun. Impactless Sites is next. They just got a bunch of people, I think. Yeah, we're going to do... Trade Company HQ is going to be built right now. Intergalactic Supermarket. Then we're going to do that big building that we need. And xenotourism and all that stuff. Hopefully that'll increase dust a lot. How are we doing on people? We're at 1,600 people, actually. Not bad. We're gaining a lot of people just from staying here. I don't know if it was that... Can we do that exotic rations thing again? It looks like we could... It's going to consume one of the people, though. Honestly, we're growing at one person a turn. So if we just did that every turn, we could just have fun doing that, honestly. Click that, have ships go where they're going to go. And then end turn. Because those ships, we need to have... The way the ground invasions works is we need to have manpower in order to take over anything. We need to have a lot of manpower, in fact. Hero available for recruitment. With the creation of your first trade company, HQ, you've taken a big step towards sweet import-export business. Construct your first trade company subsidiary that will allow a trade route to be established.
All right. Got it. Create trade routes. Good to go. So we can do Craver or Horatio Overseer. I don't know who I want to go with more. I feel like the Horatio guy, just to keep pured. As the minnow becomes the shark, so mistrust becomes hatred. Come then, let our empire slip this. Okay. All right. Well, this ship is going to have to run. Oh my goodness. Brig 2222222. 103. What? Oh, jeez. Oh my gosh. 490. Oh no. Oh, I should have already done ground war to swallow these guys up. Oh. All right. Well, this is not going to be good. Yep. Ground battle at Umero. They've got 240 infantry. Ha 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 ha. Local resistance. We're gonna have to watch this. There's no way we can't watch this. Oh, I'm so sorry. I didn't know we were losing our battle that poorly. I did not take the correct road to get here. They have so many more people. They have so many more people. Oh, that's so many laser gun blasts. We're going down so many people. Oh, goodness. No, 56. We took down 10% of their guys. Oh, that is just a wave of death, isn't it? Oh. We're down to 21%. Oh, yeah, that 21% is gone. Yep. Yep. Yep, 0%. Gone. 82% left. Oh, we have to take that planet back. Ooh, God. This entire war has been over that stupid little complex. Right now, we have to load up our people with... Oh. Do you think that they're going to rest right there? Do you think they're going to come to the capital? Or are they going to pick off all the little systems first? That is enraging. That is enraging to me. Ugh. He's joined our empire. Well, great. Horatio's increased there. Wonderful. We got Airy. What are you guys good at? You guys are good at science. Work on science. What else do we have? We have Aselius, which is our main place. We're gonna have to keep doing exotic rations until our crew is fed. Because I think we're going up. Yeah, we're going up every turn with that. I guess it took us just way too long to get everything situated. Oh. Makes me feel sick. Oh. Okay, we have one impactless site. So, once we get impactless sites and we open up the next layer of... we probably need more research to open up the next layer of upgrades. Because we need that unobtainium stuff to get the Imperator class hole. Because it needs 5 of both of those advanced stuff. So we're going to have to go through the super advanced things. Okay. Until we get to further down. Oh, well, the first shots of war have just been fired. Can we go into diplomacy and force them into a peace treaty? The Sofons really don't like us. Click to negotiate with this empire. We don't have any diplomatic stuff? Really? We can't force truce with anybody? What research is forced truce? Because we're going to have to do that and then come back swinging. Because I don't think we can win this war right now with that huge warship they have. That's overcolonization. Treaty. Allows you to create, join, and align. Nope. It's not what I need. Overcolonization. Boo, 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 boo. Cultural flexibility.
which would be very good, but that's not what I need. Where's force truce? I need some way to force a truce onto these guys.
I don't think that's science.
Oh, I don't know what that is. Maybe we have to be at war for a certain amount of turns before I can do a truce.
Oh, well, the war for Ugaro is back. We're at war again with the Lumeris.
They have a giant death machine that was like 4,000 or something health points, which is very, very much going to outmatch every single ship that we have. Even our missile frigates are not going to be a match for that. We have just another warship on the way over there, which is not going to help. I don't know why I sent it over there. They're going to get in a fight with this caravel anyway. Oh, which is going to put up a fight. Oh boy. Well, that's the politics of destruction for you. But anyway, I hope you guys have enjoyed us going through this campaign. I'm sorry we're still stuck in this little area. I am not as skilled at this game as I thought I was. Anyway, we're going to continue our war with the Lumeris. We're going to sweep after we destroy their super powerful crazy ship and sweep up to the north. I think we're going to go after the Lumeris, then the Sofons because their technology scares me. And then we're just going to go on a rampage once we have stabilization, but we don't have the technology. Next time, we're going to focus on getting the rare materials that we need to build our super ships, and then we're going to go after them hard. That's going to be the swing back that we need to defeat them. I can't believe Ugaro was destroyed so quickly. We really needed to invest in industrial things there. I'm sorry it started out like this, but at least it makes it more exciting for the next episode. If you like this, please hit like and subscribe. It really helps me out a lot. Helps me, you know, keep informed on what you guys like. I've been having fun with this series so far, and I continue to keep going until the Horatio make the galaxy beautiful or we die. Anyway, thank you so much. This has been Endless Space. I've been Mehappydude, and as always, stay happy.